Hello everyone, we are Oliver Hahn
and Christoph Reich
presenting our CVPR highlight paper, Scene-Centric Unsupervised Panoptic Segmentation, a joint work with Nikita Araslanov, Daniel Cremers, Christian Rupprecht and Stefan Roth.
Our goal is to predict panoptic maps from a monocular scene-centric image without any form of human supervision. A panoptic mask assigns a semantic class label to every pixel while detecting individual object instances. We only train using unlabeled stereo videos. The high-level idea of our approach is to exploit unsupervised optical flow, depth, and self-supervised visual representations to generate panoptic pseudolabels. Training on these pseudolabels yields a strong unsupervised panoptic segmentation approach. While several works approach unsupervised semantic or instance segmentation, we are only aware of a single existing unsupervised panoptic segmentation approach, U2SEG by New et al. While performing unsupervised panoptic segmentation, U2SEG suffers from low-resolution semantic pseudolabels and bypasses the panoptic thing-stuff separation. Finally, U2SEG requires object-centric training data, meaning images with one main object in the foreground and a uniform background. Applying mask cut, the core instance pseudo-labeling approach of U2SEG to scene-centric images fails. Consequently, U2SEG performs poorly on scene-centric data, while our approach overcomes these limitations. We present CUPS for scene-centric unsupervised panoptic segmentation. CUPS is composed of two main components. First, we generate panoptic pseudo-labels using stereo frames, as well as unsupervised motion and depth maps. Second, we train a monocular panoptic network using our unsupervised pseudo-labels and perform self-training. To generate unsupervised panoptic pseudo-labels, we first perform instance pseudo-labeling by detecting moving objects. Using an off-the-shelf unsupervised dense correspondence network, depth and flow are estimated. Lifting these to scene flow, instance masks are generated using a Sommeling-based scene flow to SE3 motion clustering, assuming rigid motions. Merging and filtering masks yield scene-centric instance pseudo-labels. Semantic pseudo-labeling employs a state-of-the-art unsupervised semantic segmentation network. However, this network only predicts low-resolution semantic maps. We perform sliding window inference and present a depth-guided semantic inference approach to obtain high-resolution semantic pseudo-labels. Finally, we align instances and semantics, resulting in high-precision panoptic pseudo-labels and estimate a thing-stuff split of the semantic pseudo-classes. Note, all pseudo-labeling components are fully unsupervised.
We train a monocular panoptic network using our pseudo-labels. As our panoptic pseudo-labels only capture moving objects, we use a drop-loss strategy and present a self-enhanced copy-paste augmentation. During training, we copy confident instance predictions of the panoptic network and paste these into the other images, aiding generalization to static objects. To enhance segmentation accuracy and further generalize to static objects, we present a panoptic self-training. Using a student-teacher framework, we perform multi-scale augmentations and construct self-labels from the model's predictions. Applying strong photometric augmentations on the input image, we train the panoptic network using the self-labels and update the momentum network using an exponential moving average. We train CUPS on pseudo-labels obtained on the cityscape's training sequences and evaluate on the cityscape's validation set, as well as five different datasets showcasing generalization beyond the training data. CUPS outperforms the state-of-the-art by a significant margin and generalizes to different datasets, including an out-of-distribution dataset. Notably, the accuracy between datasets is stable, different from the supervised equivalent trained on cityscapes, which performs well on the training domain but breaks under a slight domain shift. Qualitatively, we observe that CUPS discovers a large number of instances and accurately detects and segments small and distant objects. CUPS suffers from fewer artifacts and fewer wrong predictions, while being more temporally consistent compared to U2SEG. To conclude, we presented CUPS for unsupervised scene-centric panoptic segmentation. We effectively combined motion and depth cues with self-supervised visual representations for unsupervised panoptic scene understanding. CUPS significantly improved unsupervised panoptic accuracy on scene-centric data and generalizes to various domains. In addition, we achieve state-of-the-art performance in unsupervised semantic and instance segmentation, as well as strong label-efficient learning results, which we show in the paper. Our code and pre-trained models are publicly available, and we hope you find CUPS useful in your work.